машин считаюсь. Nu, ma, ma, mašīna no tā neapstāsies, tas skaidrs. Nē, nu nerāda kopsumu, nerāda tekošu. Varētu būt, Ja tur vispār nekā nav, varbūt, ka vienkārši paneļu barošana ir pazūdus. Nu, es nezinu. Labi, manu lekcija tagad notiek. Ok, jā. So, I have started the broadcast. You can see. One moment, I will publish in auto system. One moment. I just need to start editing. Knowing one live viewer. Why we have only one live viewer? It is not right. It is definitely wrong. We should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. guess it will be. So everybody has a link on a live stream. I see only one person connected. Anybody hear me? Connected. Two viewers. Okay, I'll go there.
Right.
I want to show one thing. It's a demo. One small demo. What I got here? Do you see a simple chart and this violet line? It's a again our rectangular signal. I drawn it from degrees. It is not important. Important. Let me repeat our previous let's say experiment. Here is our original line. I have added a component with the frequency of our original signal. First harmonic or base frequency. You can see it as a blue line. As we know, we can approximate a rectangular signal, this meander, as a row. One unit of the first harmonic or base frequency plus 1/3. Here you can see spectral diagram with the added 1/3 of the triple frequency. I can write this. First harmonics, third harmonic, and the sum. Can you see the mouse moving? I'm not sure. Okay, you see how mouse moves on the screen. Okay, let's see. Oh, one more. Original, first, third, fifth. One unit of the base frequency, 1/3 of the triple frequency, 1/5 of the five time is base frequency on the fifth harmonic. This will yield us this nice line. I can clear original one. That's what we see in real from my large generator. Let's try to get more precise approximation. 1 second, clear, original. Now I have five components, first five row elements. You can see it's closer, but we still have this area. It's called this one's called overshot. Okay, I'll try to add 15, first 15 elements. See the blue line? Now row contains 15 elements, you can see as a chart. Close. And at this area, everything okay. But at the starting, at the end, at the break point, break moments, we still have an error. Okay, I'll take 50 elements. Now, row contains, you can see, 50 elements. It's closer to original signal, but we still see these decaying oscillations, I may say, at the break point. Good. 150. Very nice, except this point, this point, this point. Still, we can see, still see an error. What's the problem? What's going on? Why? We have problem here. Fourier row works strange. Honest, let's say the non-continuous or discontinuous signals at the breakpoints. This problem is known for many years. When Fourier just wanted to publish his work on this series approximation, Lagrange, famous French mathematician, strictly opposed Fourier work, saying no, it will not work, it will produce a terrible error on a step-like function. In our case, we see rectangular signal is it's approximated. But this spike still remains. In the in our business, in theory of signal, this problem is often called as a Gibbs Gibbs problem or Gibbs phenomenon, or in Latvian Gibbs Gibbs paradox or Gibbs paradox. So Gibbs phenomenon problem, what we see with Fourier series, approximate non-continuous signals with an error. We need to take a deeper look. The question is how, how severe is this problem? What's an error produced by this Gibbs phenomenon? Okay, we need to do something. switch myself to my blackboard. And let's try to understand how serious is the problem of Gibbs phenomenon, or what's an impact on precision. The root, let's say, the root case, the root source of the Gibbs phenomenon is in the idea of Fourier approximation at this point when Euclid norm was taken as a precision criterion. Fourier weights or Fourier coefficients ensure best possible approximation by the row, by the series, but best possible in terms of Euclid norm. This means what sharp changes are, let's say, it's not a good word, neglected, but they are smoothened. So Gibbs paradox is the other side of the precision, let's say, of idea what we will approximate periodic function with a set of functions which are integrable with a square, and precision is evaluated by the Euclid norm. Okay. Gibbs idea sounds like, let's say we have something bigger as a function of x. But in some point A, A minus epsilon, it will be A capital, and A plus epsilon, it will be D. Function with a break. Non-continuous or discontinuous function. We have a switch, let's say, at a point A. Gibbs offered or introduced function, genome, Gibbs function, which is minus zero and one is our well-known function. Gibbs function. Assuming E1 and X being a particular case of our well-known rectangular function. For the merit of simplicity, Gibbs converts the argument to the angular function. So, as we know, Fourier rule for such function sorry will yield something like IP multiply by 1/3 plus 1/5 sine x and so on. Or change from 1 divided b multiply. From here I will have sine 2 minus 1 x divided interrupted f can be replaced with plus f1 x some uninterruptible or continuous function. We can represent a breakpoint or interruption introducing Gibbs with the help, let's say, with the help of the Gibbs function. Okay, okay. Will be so if we are interested in a Fourier law near the breakpoint, it's sufficient for us to understand what's going on with the Gibbs function at the area near zero. We should understand when x moves towards zero, Gibbs function maybe towards one or minus one, depending on from which side we are approaching zero. One from the opposite minus one. Zero. But Fourier law we have a approximated with some, but this is some when x moves to zero, it's to zero because it is uninterrupted. It contains of multiple signs, but every sign, all signs in the world are uninterrupted,
are continuous. But Gino X is this not continuous. It discontinuous, it has a break point. We have a collision here. Good. Let's take a look on SN not X. It's a one. A sum of the first n elements. Maybe I should keep it. It's a sum of first n elements. Here's my example. At this moment, I have 25 elements. So n now is 25, and a blue line. Can you see the blue line? The blue line is Sn as a function from x. Snx is this blue line. And I can go back. To do so, we can see some oscillators. We need to perform a search for extreme. If we want to find this peak, we need to perform a simple analyze. Solve this equation, it will give us this x, which corresponds to the biggest error or highest in precision. Let's test the sum of elements for extreme. Something like cosine plus 5x and so on, or it's p sum. Cosine minus 1 x
equals to 0. Gibbs' new theory of complex function, better than I. In the theory of complex function, there is one nice progression. Multiply 1 plus f beta plus f bar plus and so on can be replaced with beta divided by 1 beta. It's such kind of progression appears when we start up of generators or something like this. It's a decaying row of vectors shifted by same angle at every step. So where's the profit of this row? If we take a real part of it, we can take a real part of it. What will it will give us? 1 second. If we have some kind of, let's say, x equals to, let's say, phi is f, what's your imaginary, its real part, I will will be its like cosine of phi. Imaginary part will be multiplied by sine phi, but we need cosine. So, real part of this will be cosine from alpha plus alpha plus cosine alpha plus and so on. Thank you. is a little bit similar to what we want. Something close. So, we have some, okay, I will write it more correct. We have something like Sn of m elements being sum from 1 such as some. If we calculate elements one by one sequentially, S alpha. Let's take last element. Here we have a cubed by 2 multiplied by this can be simplified. S A power J alpha plus M minus 1 beta multiplied by sine M divided by sine beta. It's an one moment. It's an element, not a sum, it's an element with the number M. Now I need to separate a real part from this. So for last element, we will get something like this. Sine m by 2. Sine multiplied with cosine alpha plus m minus 1 bet plus sine alpha plus m minus 1 bet by 2 and now we need only real part. We can drop this off. For element number m, we will have something like cosine of m minus 1 bet by multiplied by sine by 2 divided by sine 2. It's an nth element. Sum of n to elements will be sum change from 1 to n capital cosine alpha plus one bet multiplied by sine divide bet. Okay, and what's on? Now we can do a trick. Let's assume bet equals double x and alpha double x. This means what sum cosine minus 1 x can be one cosine divided by sine x.
Or 1/2 of sine x divided by sine x. X can be represented as 1/2 without any sign. Sine 2nx divided by sine no x without any sign. And we can also show it as 0 to x. Starting from 0 and ending with y. For us, it's we can limit. We need extrema points. Extrema points, now we can find them easy. Solving this equation. Extrema points are at x equals copy divided by 2n. Here k is an integer 1, 2, 3 till n. Number of the extrema. This one will be the first. Equals, we need to introduce y equals to nt, and this will also to write 2 divided by p, 0 to p, so divided n sine. Thank you.
What can we say about this integral? If we have more and more components, number of elements moves to infinity. That's good. We have number of elements here, so this will shift to this tends to zero, and as we know, sine or small angle are near equal to the angles themselves. So sine shifts to something like
it's known. Or something known as Wilbraham-Gibbs constant.
Something like 1, 1, 7, 9, so on. TV Wikipedia 0. It's an integral signs. So now we can make a conclusion. This overshoot is less than 18%. This function is it's a table function, integral sign.
So Gibbs phenomenon says tells us what? What will have an over shot of at max 18%. It's a maximum amplitude error. sine integral of p. You can, if interesting, you can find it in tables. Anyway, conclusion of Gibbs paradox.
Drawing. Will be here too.
When we replace discontinuous signal with the Fourier series, maximum, the worst case, the highest possible error is 18% at the first overshoot. Others will be better. Just let's see. Just keep in mind this idea: Fourier rho represents signal approximated signals to produce a best fit, but in average. On a sharp changes, Fourier rho will overshoot. And in worst case scenario, as we see it, Gibbs function or Gibbs phenomenon, we will have 18% overshoot. G. Willard Gibbs. Born 1899. Okay. Any questions? I have a feeling we can end for today.